Uh-oh.
They got this listed as a 2000 Chrysler 300, but this looks a bit newer than that. The customer states the buttons on the steering wheel don't work and the power steering doesn't work. They want me to find out why, see if I can make it work. That's what I do. Let's see. Yeah, definitely no power steering. Thanks for tuning in, guys. This has got a 129,391 miles on this Chrysler 300. And I'm glad you're here. We're gonna take a look at this thing, see what's going on with the power steering and the horn buttons. Traction lights on, airbag lights on, you didn't ask about that. Probably got a clock spring problem and a power steering leak. Unless it's electric power steering. Let's see if it's really a 2000. 3 of 2014. So, as usual, Paul Harvey is on task. Let's drive this thing around and see what's going on with the power steering. I wouldn't be surprised. Some kind of a fuse, electrical problem. Because there's a couple of lights on that weren't mentioned. Well, enough speculation. Let's do it. This thing has got a brand new alternator. And I don't see a power steering pump, so it has electric power steering. Let me grab my test light. And we'll run through and check all these fuses. We might fix all of his problems with a fuse. If he's really lucky. Of course, I've also had to replace whole fuse panels in these. All right, guys, after going on Identifix and learning a little bit more about the steering system in this 2000/2014 Chrysler 300, the non-SRT cars use electro-hydraulic power steering, which has an electric power steering pump. I did find the fuses I need to check. These three fuses are my primary targets. But since it's got electrical stuff and modules involved, I'm gonna pull codes first. 2014, 5.7 liter. We'll go in there and we'll see what kind of codes we have, and then I'll run out and check the fuses real quick. I'm assuming I'll have no communication, stuff like that, but let's see. All right, guys, those are my codes. I'm about to clear them out and see what happens, and then I will go out and check the fuses. I find the best way to test these fuses is to pop the cover off. You can check both legs that way without disturbing it. And that fuse is good. That's the power steering fuse. And the other fuse we're interested in is 39 10 amp power steering module fuse. That's good. That's good. Uh-oh. Power steering fuse is good. We got no power steering. That's a bad sign. Now we're gonna have to dig down to that bad Johnny. I'm gonna have to get down to the module itself and see if there's power and ground going into the module. All right, this Chrysler 300 monstrosity. It's been in a front end accident. It's got new paint that's like a Mako level. I'm gonna check the power steering fluids on top of the electric pump in the wheel well here. It's looking like it probably has two separate problems. Probably low fluid level and a bad steering column control module, because none of the steering wheel controls work, the horn, cruise, the paddle switches, none of that works or responds to input on the scan tool, reading the PIDs. But supposedly the power steering would work even if that is not working, which I'm wondering if that's true, because without the information from there, it wouldn't know what to do, right? Well, luckily I looked at the PIDs and I can see steering angle on the data PIDs, so it should know what's going on with that. Long story short, make sure the fluid level's good before I start to chase on my tail. This is where Chrysler hid the power steering fluid reservoir. Gotta get that cap off, get a look at that level in there. I don't know if you guys will be able to fit in there with me, but... Let's see. Oh, come on, light. Studio lighting could also be a fender brace, you know. I didn't know if you guys knew that, but... Weird too is someone's just put that alternator on like I was showing you, so that kind of sent me down the rabbit hole thinking of electrical problems first, but I gotta at least look at this fluid level if the cap comes off at all. There's fluid in there, but it's definitely not looking real good. Let me get my other flashlight. So I guess what I gotta do is measure with my pocket screwdriver the minimum level. See if I get fluid. Yep, J just barely. So it's not the fluid level. That's terrible. When I look in the scan tool data for this pump, I get it shows power and ground with the engine running. So this thing may have a bad pump, or unlike what the flowchart nonsense says, that steering column control module is not telling us what to do.
That's very possible. Let's take a look at that further.
All right, I've been gathering data on this Chrysler 300, and it looks like we have two separate problems, because everything I'm reading in a description of operation, and the power steering system should work regardless of what the steering column control module does, as long as you have, even if you don't have steering angle input, then it defaults to a certain value, and all you lose is the variable assist. In other words, it'll be a little stiff in a parking lot, or in other situations, it could be a little light on the highway, but you'll still have power steering assist. And you can see here where I have, it's showing my voltage, and it's also showing the temperature, and it's showing the pump motor speed, but when I go out there to the pump, nothing's happening. I can hear something, but nothing's really happening. If I turn the steering wheel, you can watch the pump speed up. It raises the RPM of the pump. So there's definitely got, this thing has a bad power steering pump and a bad steering column control module. So I'm gonna assume he drove it with the steering column control module not working for a while and none of the switches responding. And the clock spring's bad, no horn, no switches, no paddle shifters. So the clock spring's bad, causing those problems, and he's been driving it that way. But now that the power steering pump motor stopped working, now he wants it fixed. So I made the assumption, I wasted a little bit of time trying to prove that it was because of this. But since I have good power and grounds down at the pump, and it thinks it's running, so I could put my hand on it and see if I can feel it. Let's do that. But obviously there's zero power steering and the fluid's full. So if the motor's turning, then it's cut and dry, that we've got two separate problems. So we'll go out and feel on that motor. I can hear the motor running. It's pretty quiet though, but the radiator support is not running. The motor's running. Let's see where we go with this one. All right, guys. Starting up this Chrysler 300C. I'm gonna do the clock spring first, and then the electric power steering pump afterwards. I got the airbag off already. Super Mario, Super Rosario Mario. Just two 10 millimeter bolts. They go in from the back. You gotta pop the little trim cover off the shifter paddle. And then there's a 10 millimeter screw you can see from each side. Comes through right here, so. I don't have any impact hexes. So, I'm just gonna put this on my 3/8 impact and see if it'll pop this loose. If not, I'll go to the half inch, but I think it'll get it. We'll see. It won't. Time to get the big guns. Now we'll see if the mid torque half inch will do it. Oh yeah, that wasn't even close. Piece of cake. That's a serious bolt. Connectors in the way. Little tiny catch in there. Right here. That's how you get that out. I might need to get a pick. That is a tiny little guy. Bill, you need an assault blowgun for that. Rayman Ray made an assault blowgun. It's way cooler than your blowgun. I'm gonna have to get a pick. I can't get it with my pocket screwdriver. Probably because it's snap-on. I'm gonna have to give that away with one of the auctions I list. I'll just throw this in there. If this little sucker. Aha. All right. Pick to the rescue. Uh-oh. That's a heck of a vibration weight. Don't lose that, you're gonna need it. Oh, another thing too, these airbags. You have to put them facing up, by the way, if they're still live. If you put it facing like that, if the thing does somehow magically go off, which I've never had it happen, but I hear that it can. If it does go off, this would be a projectile into the air. If you face it this way and the airbag goes off, then it just goes poof, and it'll actually push itself down. And nothing will happen except you'll poop your pants. So hopefully you're wearing brown underwear. All right, there's the clock spring, AKA steering column module. So we're gonna do this whole thing. It's a one piece assembly. Pretty easy shot. When something's not working through the clock spring, you have to replace the whole steering column module. Cut this back cover off here so you don't damage it. You should be able to just tug this off. Then, once you figure out the cool electrical connector, boom. Oh, don't forget the air freshener. You want to leave that off. And once you get it all installed, then you break this little tab on there that keeps this from turning on the new one. Once you get it all installed, you pop that off of there. The new one has this the red lock tab on there. You snap off when you get it installed. And the steering column is marked too. This centering mark, I don't know if it comes up on camera, but that was already there. I didn't put it there, so that's how you make sure the steering wheel is all lined up. It's a very fine spline, although there is a flat here, so it should make you line it up, but just in case, there is a mark. So, and this should just be a snap in connector, snap it back in place, put this trim on there, should be a piece of cake. Let's see. Amazing how flimsy it all really is when it's not quite back together yet. Everything kind of flops around, but it just clips in place. This thing, now that everything's lined up, just pop it off of there. Throw it with the piece I took off that I didn't need to, because it comes with a new one. Two airbag wires. Come on now. I know you fit. You came out. Sometimes if you sing a happy tune or whistle, it helps, makes it go together smooth. Now I must find my notches. There we go. Alright. Get my connectors in. The steering wheel pushes the bolt, pushes the steering wheel on that last quarter inch to take all that play out of there and sink the wheel onto the spring, pushes the clock spring together. And then these three connectors go to the airbag. One's blue, right? So blue to blue. These don't have any memory in them because that's new, came with the clock spring. So the colors are coordinated. The battery is disconnected, by the way. You always want to disconnect the battery and give it a few minutes before you start taking the airbag out, because there's a capacitor that stores energy. So the airbag will work if the battery's damaged in a crash. Two screws from the back. This is going to be interesting. I might have to use my magnet to start them, because not a lot of room to fit the socket in there. Steering pump almost falls out from that point. Pull this out here. Just, it's like a snap-on noise cover. But once you pull this out of the holder, you can turn it and get to the lines. These clip removal tools also work good for pulling electrical connectors off. Usually. There you go. Alright, I'm trying to be sneaky, taking these bolts out, slipping it out of the bracket. But they're also sneaky, and they put a bolt here hidden in this between these two brackets. So you got to take the two main bolts out of the front and these two bolts out and take it out of the bracket on the bench so that you can get to this bolt. Sneaky sun gums, man. I got to get a torch to hook, unhook the lines too and let it drip for a little bit. Now, you got to pop this hose off while you hold the bracket and don't let the pump fall, even though it's getting replaced. But I still don't like the crashing sound and the gravity test. Let's see if we can do that. Yeah, that was gonna happen. Making quite a mess over here, mister. Alright. Yeehaw! Look at that conglomeration of fantabulous engineering. New O-ring. Always change those O-rings. Oh, that's kind of nice. Kind of holds it for you a little bit. Get this past the bumper. Now, find my return line. There it is. Working by braille. It's exciting. Now I can do my pressure line. Needs a little bit of love. There we go. Man, you can see how you're just bumping into somebody in a parking lot. That thing's sticking out under the front bumper. The brace is above it, but still. You hit something in the road, it's going to hit your power steering and take it out. Kind of a odd setup, but this is like the third one of these we've done already. So it's going to be a pretty popular item, I would think, in the next couple of years. Putting some of this really cool, special fluid, power steering electro-hydraulic fluid. It's really hard to see the level. So I find shining a light in there, show me where the level's at. So it looks like it's right at max right now. So I'm going to turn the key on, see how this thing goes. Even though this isn't an electric car, it still needs electric to run. Kind of the way electric cars need oil to run. All right, let's fire Mario's car up here. Automatic I-beams. Hey, the buttons work on a steering wheel. Yay! Looks like I gotta do some initializing. I gotta put the tires on the ground to see to make sure the power steering works, but I mean, it's so light without right now, so it's got to be doing something. I don't even feel like a rack and pinion at this point. I'm going to rock the wheel back and forth about 5 times, then go out, turn the engine off, and check the power steering fluid. Make sure it's at the max line still. I think we're going to be good. I know the buttons work. So it's just going to be a matter of setting everything to where the customer might like, or advising the customer that it has to be done. And I'm going to check for code, see why the traction light's on. Just the fact that the fluid went down a little bit, you know everything's working correctly. If this pump wasn't working for some reason and I had misdiagnosed it, the fluid level wouldn't have changed at all, right? Because the pump wasn't doing anything before, so. I got to put a couple more ounces in there, and we should be good to go. Put the wheel liner in, take it for a drive. I'm and take this thing for a drive. Got good power steering, everything's working. Yay, it's fixed. It's on the ground. All right, guys, I hope you got something from that video. Power steering pump and clock spring module, what they call steering column control module. So thanks for watching, guys. Give me a thumbs up, a like, torque that like. If you got something good from this video, I appreciate that. It'll help the channel. And check out the description. I have my Amazon store set up. Traction light went out. Everything's good. Win, 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 win. I appreciate the support. You guys are awesome. I'll see you in the next video.